Let me guess, you're here because your laptop disk is full. So you're looking to minimize that disk space and to keep your Lightroom running fast. Then this video is for you guys. 1.2 is up to like. Hey guys, my name is Morgan Tolentino. I'm a full-time photographer with the help of automation and business planning. I grew my wedding photography business from zero to 30 plus weddings a year in 24 months, and I'm here to help you do the same. So, your laptop is running low on space, and you know that it's your Lightroom's catalogs. So today we're gonna talk a little bit about Lightroom catalogs, and then we're gonna jump over onto my actual MacBook and show you guys how we can move our Lightroom catalogs to external drives. So let's take a quick step back for a moment and explain what a catalog is. A catalog is gonna be the database where it's gonna track your Lightroom edits, the way that you organize your Lightrooms, it's gonna organize your photos, etc. And those changes are saved within the catalog themselves. The photo files themselves aren't touched necessarily when in the catalog, and it's important to better understand the way that catalogs work to help us determine where we should kind of store things and map things out within our own systems. So when you start Lightroom for the very first time, what it's going to do is create a Lightroom catalog onto your laptop or onto your PC, right? When you do that and you start to use that, you are going to quickly bog down that computer. And the reason is because you are storing the catalogs and you're creating the backups for the images within that hard drive. So the goal of this video is going to help you guys to move everything to externals. And that's gonna keep your Lightroom speed running, it's gonna keep your disk utility low. Overall, it's just gonna make your life a heck of a lot easier. But before we jump over, let's talk about some of the reasons that you would want to do that other than just speed, right? So ideally, yes, we don't wanna bog down our computers and that's gonna help with speed, but it's also going to allow for you to expand your Lightroom catalogs quicker and for storage space of your data and photos. It's also gonna make it easier to organize and backup your data. So moving your catalogs from your actual computer onto externals is also gonna add a little bit of a layer of protection there. And I'm gonna explain that with kind of a personal horror story. So, story time. A few years ago, I was already practicing using external drives plugged into my laptop when my oldest daughter ended up spilling a giant cup of Sprite onto my MacBook and instantly fried the MacBook. I was able to just unplug my external, set it aside while we took MacBook to IT guy. It was done for. It's okay. My insurance covered it. But my business insurance was able to get me my money quickly to replace the MacBook. But as soon as my new MacBook came in, I was able to just take this and immediately plug it into the next one, and everything was able to pull up exactly where I had left off. So I really only lost a few days of editing while we were ordering a new laptop versus losing all of those photos and that data in those catalogs had those been on the actual computer themselves. That in itself, that story and that day, was enough for me to become extremely OCD, and I now do not have any Lightroom catalog on my regular computer drive at all. So now that we've talked about, you know, those two or three reasons that we should move to external hard drives, let's go ahead and jump over to my MacBook and I'll show you how we do it. Okay, so we've made it into Lightroom now, right? And again, the goal is to keep as much off of our internal as possible to keep speeds going quicker. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start here in Lightroom. This is my most recent catalog that I've been working on. And I'm gonna go to File, New Catalog. Now, normally what I do is I do first names, right, whatever. I use one catalog per
wedding. And then I also use a catalog per season for engagement, family, personal, things like that. We'll go into the season. So I'll do like spring 2022, summer 2022, fall 2022. But then my individual weddings will each individually get a new catalog. Everybody does this differently. Some people like to do just one new catalog for the entire year and then to do subfolders within that catalog for different weddings. That works too. This part really is just kind of a preference. I like being able to stay focused as somebody with ADHD. I like to have a Lightroom catalog dedicated to the individual weddings to keep me more focused when I'm working on editing. All right, so here on the where, you'll notice that we are on our external drive that we've put in. My Samsung T5 happens to be a solid state drive, which if you don't understand what solid state drives are versus drives with, you know, moving parts in them or stuff, make sure that you're doing a little bit of research on that before you commit to external hard drives, right? All right, so we're gonna hit create. This is going to self-populate a new Lightroom catalog. So now this Lightroom catalog is actually on that external hard drive. Now, when we go to import our photos into this drive, all of these steps are gonna be pointless unless we're also, when we're creating the copies or the backups through Lightroom, that you are also doing that on that external hard drive as well. So I'm gonna plug in an SD card. Wait for a prompt. Perfect, okay. So we're gonna see over here is right now, this is my internal. What it wants to do is make a copy of all of these images to my internal pictures folder, which is what Lightroom does automatically, which is why your system will get bogged down so quickly. So we're gonna go down here, we're gonna click other destination. What I like to do is go to that same drive. So we're gonna go to other destinations. I wanna go to that same drive. And I actually like to pick the same folder. And it's just gonna go ahead and create a new subfolder within this folder that also has the Lightroom catalog. Again, everybody's gonna have different preferences. All right, so of course, you know, once you went through here and you had selected which images are going in, whether you call before or after, that is up to you and your preferences. Now, your options here, right? So now when we are making a copy of these images and importing them into our Lightroom, our copies are going to be on that same external hard drive. So what that means is that when we move that external hard drive to any laptop or computer that has Lightroom, you would be able to plug and go and be able to export your images. I know that some people like to do just a build a smart preview, but then if you did that, you would pull out your, you know, your hard drive anyway. So now that we've selected that we are going to make a copy of these images to the same external hard drive, we're going to do this so that we can move that external hard drive between laptops, through desktops, etc. I know there's a million different ways to do this, but honestly, at the end of the day, I feel like there's no right or wrong reason as long as you are protecting these images and you are able to make sure that you can plug and play, essentially, if something was to happen to your actual laptop or desktop, right? So we've got don't import suspected duplicates, obviously. And I personally do not do build smart preview. There's pros and cons to both. It's just something that I've never done. I've had done it here and there, but it just doesn't feel necessary. I like my system, and my system has never failed me, so there's no point in changing it. All right, so we're gonna put import. All right, so As you can see, we are now in a brand new Lightroom catalog that is on our external. We are also in then imported brand new photos into this Lightroom catalog, but those photos are also still being stored on the external. The reason that I did it that way is so that I don't have to pick and choose which of my laptop or my hard laptop or my desktop I have to use in order to export the final images, because the RAWs and the original photos are also on that same external. I don't necessarily have a smart preview up on my laptop in order to edit, and then when I have to export those, I have to go back to my desktop where my external hard drive might be plugged in there. As long as I have my external hard drive, it doesn't matter which one I'm plugging it into, I'm able to export in the full sizes and not have to do a smart preview. Okay, so hopefully that will help you guys clear up some space. This is going to keep that Lightroom catalog, again, off of your internal drive, and it's going to help keep RAWs off of your internal drive, which means that you can still be using your desktops and your laptops to keep that speed going for all of the other important parts of your business. And anyway, I hope this was super helpful. I, again, am by no means an expert on this, but this is the system that I've been using for about 5 years. It works really well for me. And if you guys have questions, leave them in the comments below. Hopefully I can answer them. If not, I'll definitely help you find the answer to them. And in the meantime, have a great day, you guys.